Hey guys, I had a bad game against Kappa Wall in the last one, so I'm going to try to fix the problem by playing GM Orange from Israel. The problem being that I used way too much time in this last game, and I'm not pleased by it. Alright, so we have a King's Indian attack position. He transposed it into like a Sicilian. I'm going to go A5. And then I'm going to play bishop here. No, queen here. In the same diagonal as his bishop. So his idea is F5. I think that's pretty clear. Knight H4. Oh no, he has this move. Oops. No, he doesn't. Does he? Yeah, knight takes a5, rook takes a5, queen takes a5. I have knight takes. But he can go knight takes a5, rook takes a5, bishop takes c4, I believe. That would work for him. He's a GM, so I expect him to find it. He did not find it. But now I got to defend against that threat. A6 can be met by B5. That would not be good. Let's go here. Lucky break for me that he missed that move. I think I should try to play for some sort of counterplay in the center, like maybe pawn F4 soon. It's using a decent amount of time. What about A6? What are you going to do about that? Knight C7? A6, knight C7. That's what he'll do about that. F4? No. Let's go 93. If he trades, I'll take with a bishop. He can go F4 and then just bishop D2. I'm not sure who's better in this position. Some intimidating pawns, though. Very intimidating. All right, let's shake this up. I got him to take that way, at least. I have yet to develop my dark square bishop. I should likely do that. Yeah, let's just do it. Keep it simple. I have an eye towards eventually playing bishop F1. Yeah, bishop f1 and maybe put the bishop on c4. Attempt to trade with him. Let's go here. He'll probably occupy the file. Does not want to. I feel like he can land knight on d4 with decisive effect somewhere. Well, I'm not actually sure I should take that knight because he takes with his pawn. He gets like a huge pawn roller in the center. That'd be insane if I didn't take it. Let's not take it. Okay, he's just going to go win my pawn. Bad news. this move, maybe? Does that work? I'm threatening his knight on a5. Let's go here. Okay, gotta hustle now.
Time gotta warning. Hustle.
Time warnings abound. What? Oh, you can do that. Okay. Time warnings abound. Does that work?
Check.
Please tell me that works. That failed horribly. Oh, he has mate. Rook takes h2. Hello. He didn't see it. He still has, like, crushing threats, though. What am I gonna do? Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. I don't think he's gonna let this one get away from him. Nah, I'm flagged. I'm so flagged. He missed a mate in one. No. Another GM who played pretty fast. These guys are good. Leon Gofshtein is the grandmaster that I played. Yeah, I think I was worse for the vast majority of this game. Let's just check that knight bd4 move. Or knight... Was it knight bd4? Yeah, it was. Right here. I guess I should take this knight. I just had this idea like he was going to play knight bd4. Because I saw a game just the other day where Black sacrificed a knight for... I think it was two pawns. But he also was able to get, like, a big pawn roller in the center. So c takes d4, c takes d4 is the idea. I just didn't like the look of this. If I play knight c4, I just lose to pawn to d3. Then he outplayed me in the time scramble from probably a better position. Yeah, I should have gone after his f5 pawn, huh? Bishop h3. That's why it likes that move. Still edge to black, but c4, b6. He kept everything together nicely. I totally missed that rook takes b2 was threatened. And then I made it in 2, but he didn't see it. And even after that move, I can't do anything other than give up my queen. Yeah, and you guys saw the rest. All right. Well, my second loss in a row in the 3-minute pool to a GM. But, yeah, I'll throw this one up on the channel. And, I don't know, I kind of want to win a game in 3-minute. So I'll probably make my next video a 3-minute video, too. All right, thanks for tuning in, guys. Please leave me any feedback in the comments. Have a good one.